The Oscar award-winning movie Argo tells the real-life story of the rescue operation that saved six Americans during the Iran hostage crisis. In a CNN exclusive, our own Alina Cho sat down with five of the U.S. consular staff who were caught up in Iran's revolution.
What happened? Six of the hostages went out a back exit.
Where are they? The Canadian ambassador's house.
In the movie Argo, Ben Affleck plays Tony Mendez, a real-life CIA operative who hatches a plan to rescue six Americans who elude capture during the Iranian Revolution.
I got an idea.
They're a Canadian film crew for a science fiction movie.
I fly into Tehran. We all fly out together as a film crew.
That fake science fiction movie is called Argo.
If I'm doing a fake movie, it's going to be a fake hit.
These are the real embassy workers on which the film is based.
What was your first thought when you saw it?
It was more exciting than the real thing.
Bob Anders, Lee Schatz, Mark and Cora Lijek, Kathleen Stafford, five of the six. The first time they've all sat down together for a TV interview. The only one who couldn't be with us is Kathleen's husband, Joe, currently working for the State Department in the Sudan.
These are the actors who played you. What do you think?
Sure looks like Joe. They even got his little sweaters, right? You know, he used to wear these little sleeveless sweater vests. That's him.
They took me back to the day, November 4th, 1979, when Iranian students climbed the wall and stormed the U.S. Embassy.
What went through your mind?
This will only last for a little while before the government will come and stop this. And I just tried to keep my staff kind of calm and collected.
I remember calling my mother after about the first 24, 48 hours and said, don't worry, you're going to see some things on the news, but I'm safe and I'll call you in a few days. And of course, I didn't call back for
79 days, they hid Iranians in the homes of Canadian diplomats and came to be known as the house guests.
People would come to the house, we'd go upstairs and hide. And at one point, there were revolutionary guards posted at the door.
Then, on January 26th, 1980...
There's a knock on the door. I open the door, and there's two guys standing there in trench coats. And I said, really? Trench coats.
Have you gotten people out this way before?
No, this is what I do, and I've never left anyone behind.
Tony's a very charming guy, very convincing.
Did you trust him?
We didn't have a whole lot of choice. I think. If we'd said, no thanks, to send in another infiltration expert.
You really believe your little story is going to make a difference when there's a gun to our heads?
I think my little story is the only thing between you and a gun to your head.
Movie spoiler alert. It worked. And once they cleared Iranian airspace...
We all ordered drinks, and I'm sure that the people on the plane, if they wondered, you know, wondered why there were these arms that went up as we made eye contact, because we were sitting in different places, but we knew why.
Alina Cho, CNN, Washington.
The former Canadian ambassador to Iran, Ken Taylor, he helped to hide those Americans. He'll join us live right here in the Situation Room during our 6 p.m. Eastern hour. Stand by for that. Tens of millions of people around the world. We both watched Ben Affleck accept an Academy Award last night for his film Argo.
Very good film. And we couldn't help but notice that the actor-director's thank you list included Canada.
I want to thank Canada. I want to thank our friends in Iran living in a terrible circumstances right now. I want to thank my wife, who I don't normally associate with Iran.
If you haven't seen it, Argo tells the story of the real-life rescue of six Americans in Iran during the 1979 hostage crisis. The movie gives most of the credit for the operation to the CIA, but in fact, Canada took the lead. The Americans were hidden in the Canadian embassy at great risk, the ambassador, Ken Taylor, who was played by actor Victor Garber.
We've got orders to close the embassy and go back. There's nowhere for them to stay.
We get caught, you and Pat go on trial for harboring the enemy, you know that.
Pat and I have discussed it. It's the risk we took.
And joining us now is the real-life former Canadian ambassador to Iran, a real hero, Ken Taylor. Ambassador, thanks very much for coming in.
Well, thanks for the invitation.
What's your reaction to Argo getting best picture?
Well, I think it's a thrilling movie. Even Pat, my wife, said to me when the first time we saw it, did we get out okay? It's sort of like the Titanic. You know the conclusion, but it draws it out until the final moment. The timing is pertinent as well. It reminds people that even 32 years later, it's a dangerous neighborhood.
But the film really doesn't give you and your Canadian colleagues, Canada, enough credit, does it? You were deeply disappointed.
Well, we, of course, took the invited, in fact, the six diplomats to stay with us. They were there with us for 3 months. We welcomed the chance to work with the CIA, but Tony Mendez was there for a day and a half and worked closely with us, but at the same time, it was essentially a Canadian operation.
Were you happy with that he at least thanked you in the credit at the end of the movie?
Yes,
the
I think so. It's indicative of the way the two countries work together. It was particularly productive in Ottawa and Washington. I worked directly with Ottawa, eventually through to Washington. The Canadians were committed to see six through. And in no sense, inconceivable, the Canadians would have closed the embassy until the six diplomats were back home.
And Ambassador, recently, former President Jimmy Carter had been asked about kind of the role of Canada and the role that you played in this hostage crisis. I want to play a little bit of that sound. Listen to this.
Sure. The only thing I would say was that 90% of the contributions to the ideas and the consummation of the plan was Canadian. And the movie gives almost full credit to the American CIA. And with that exception, the movie's very good. But Ben Affleck's character in the film was only in Tehran a day and a half. And the main hero, in my opinion, was Ken Taylor, who was a Canadian ambassador who orchestrated the entire process.
I'm sure you appreciate the words of the former President Carter, but I want to get your sense then, as he was kind of laying out really what happened, what really did happen? Walk us through, what did the movie get right and what did the movie get wrong?
Well, I think the movie takes some poetic license, as I think Hollywood is prone to do. The essential escape was a cooperative effort, but however, we were on the ground for the 3 months. It was Tony Mendez came, was deeply involved, but it was really essentially a Canadian effort with the CIA assisting us over the last day and a half.
The story
Some
was,
of the fabric, yeah.
I was going to say, the story was classified, Ambassador, for a long time. Now we all know what happened. Here's the question. How has it changed, if it has, your life or the life of the other Canadian diplomats who saved these Americans?
Well, I think that the Canadian role was personified very well in the book Our Man in Tehran. That's the source material. So I hope that Americans and Canadians not only see the movie to capture the tension, the risk and what have you of in Iran, but really capture the essence of the story by reading the book. Not quite as exciting as seeing the movie.
And real quick before we let you go, Victor Garber portrayed you in the movie. Did he do a good job?
I think he did it with grace and professionalism. I just wish you would have had a larger script.
Ambassador.
I think he agrees with you on that point, for sure.
Well, thanks. Let me thank you on behalf of all of America, for the excellent work you and your colleagues did during those critically dangerous days. A lot of us remember those 444 days that Americans were held hostage in Iran. You saved six of them, and we're grateful to you and Canada for that. Thanks very much. Republican Senator Lindsey Graham is standing by live. We're going to ask him about the 11th hour chances of a deal to avoid forced budget cuts. Also coming up, the reviews are in for the First Lady of the United States, Michelle Obama's surprise appearance at the Oscars. Stand by.